on behalf of Dr. Jack Hawkins, Jr., Chancellor of the Troy State University System, we proudly present the Troy State University Sound of the South Marching Band. Under the direction of drum major Kerry Palmer and band master Dr. Johnny Long, we're honored and thrilled to play for our wonderful alumni, our guests from Samford University, and our visiting high school bands today. We hope you enjoy our show half as much as we enjoy playing it for you. Our show today includes the Troy State Fanfare, our drill of jazz classics, Please Release Me, Boots Scootin' Boogie, and Trojans One and All. So sit back and relax. Here's the Sound of the South.
State University Marching Band, the Sound of the South, is one of the most dynamic and exciting bands in the nation today. The band's precision marching, showmanship, and outstanding musicianship have set the pattern for marching bands throughout the country. Playing original arrangements of every type of music, the Sound of the South is a great favorite with audiences everywhere. The band regularly performs for professional football halftime shows in Atlanta, Miami, New Orleans, and Tampa, and has frequently been the featured band at the Blue-Gray Classic, the Peach Bowl, and the Senior Bowl. The band has represented the state of Alabama at four presidential inaugurations. The Marching Band is the single most popular organization on the Troy State University campus, with over 260 members drawn from every school and department within the university.
Hello and welcome to the Troy State University Sound of the South 1992 season highlights. I'm Ralph Ford, assistant band director and music arranger for the Troy State Band. And with me today is the man behind the legend of the Sound of the South, the dean of the School of Fine Arts, director of bands at Troy State University for the past 28 years, Dr. John M. Long. Thank you for joining us today, Dr. Long.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here, Ralph.
Dr. Long, you first came to Troy State in 1965 from the nationally acclaimed Robert E. Lee High School Band in Montgomery. What were your expectations for the band when you first arrived on the Troy State campus?
I wanted to build a band at Troy State that would be comparable to any band in the United States, and I believed that I could do it. I was going to work hard to do that.
Another college band director had said to me this year that the Sound of the South is the most consistently exciting band year after year. How do you perpetuate the traditions of the band and motivate the students to perform well year after year?
Well, I try to encourage the students to say to enjoy the band and to have fun in the band and make it an activity where they have a fellowship. And that we've tried to make the band into a fellowship. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, the Sound of the
At Troy State University, we are fortunate to have our own fight song, one that we can call our own. You composed Trojans One and All back in 1983 while you were conducting an all-American concert band around Europe. What inspired you to give Troy State its own fight song?
I felt that Troy State should have its own fight song like some of the great schools in the Big Ten. Most of the schools in the South have fight songs that are copies of the Big Ten song. I thought Troy should have its own song.
What has motivated you to direct a band for the past 45 years, and what inspires you to keep teaching?
Because I enjoy doing it. I'd rather be band director than anything in the world, and I like to do it, and that's why I do it.
What qualities do you look for in the music that you select for the marching band to play on the field each year?
I want songs that people know, that are really standards that people are familiar with, because the purpose of our band and any band is to entertain the people, not to educate them.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to feature Troy State's trumpet section in the Harry James Classic Trumpet Blues. Trumpet section in Harry James' classic Trumpet Blues. In the inspiring hymn, How Great Thou Art.
One, two, three, play!
Yeah!
gentlemen, we'd like to thank you for being such a wonderful audience. And we hope you'll come to Troy State and be a part of our band. To conclude tonight's show, we feature our piccolo section in the official march of the United States of America, John Philip Sousa's The Stars and Stripes Forever.
One of the band's great traditions is the opening fanfare. When you composed this fanfare back in 1965, did you intend for it to become the trademark of the Sound of the South, which it has become?
Not at the time. I didn't think it'd be around as long as it has, but it says, ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention. So it has become our calling card.
Yes. Another great tradition started at Troy State by yourself was the alumni Sound of the South.
Well, I appreciate all the students coming back on homecoming. It's always a pleasure to see them, and it has worked out well.
You've often referred to music education as a three-legged stool, meaning that symphony band, marching band, and jazz band all have to be of equal importance.
That's right. If they can't read all three of and understand all three of those areas, they will have a hard time being a band director. And since we are a band director school, I think it's essential that the students be versed in all of these areas.
The backbone of any great band is the student leadership and the supporting organizations, fraternities, sororities that help out the band. How have the officers worked out with you this year and these other organizations?
The officers have been outstanding this year. They're outstanding in every way. We've always had good officers at the band, but they have just been super this year.
Mm-hmm. Well, the band, the officers are always elected by the students.
They're elected by the students. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Thank you.
many people have said that the 1992 edition of The Sound of the South was the finest band you've ever had. What are some of your thoughts as you reflect back on the season this year?
Well, it has certainly been a good season, and I don't know whether it's the best band we've ever had, but it's certainly one of the better ones, and I think when you see this tape, you'll have some idea to compare it to other bands, but I think it was certainly one of our very best ones.
And last, I'd like to ask you maybe what some of your future goals for the band program.
I want to continue doing the best we possibly can be and do the best we can do. And always try to keep the band where it's a brotherhood and a fellowship and one big fraternity in the real sense. That's the way I hope it will always be.
You've been watching the Troy State University Sound of the South Marching Band 1992 season highlights. Our special guest today was Dr. John M. Long, Dean of the School of Fine Arts and Director of Bands at Troy State University. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you on the field next year.